All right, there we go, guys. Right, I think I fixed the problem. I think I did anyway. So, hopefully I did. Because I am really getting tired of having to deal with this and the other. It's fucking annoying. But like I was saying earlier, we got stuff to talk about. First things first. And this needs to be said. No, like seriously, this needs to be said. This needs to be heard. But you will. Like this! By Cyraxx Worm. Dumbass motherfucker. Now, back to what I was saying. The other day, I was sitting down, working on some music and chilling out and hanging out, right? Well, I realized that something was going on that wasn't sitting right. And I kept thinking about it and thinking about it. Like, what could it be that wasn't sitting right? And then I figured it out. What Tibbs was saying about you trolls is 100% correct. He really is. You guys love to hide supporters. Anybody that supports me, you guys attack. You guys talk about how I don't have supporters. Like, you guys talk about how I don't have supporters, right? According to you trolls, I don't have supporters. And those were your words, right? But yet, there's video evidence that I did have supporters, and that I do have supporters. I mean, if I didn't have supporters, then why would you go after them? I see, it's pretty strange if you ask me. Don't it? I mean, if I don't have supporters, then why did you trolls go after the people that actually stood up for me or defended me, knowing what was going on? Think about that. Case in point. Foodie Beauty, who made a video defending me. But then, the minute that she defended me, you trolls attacked her. For what? For defending me? That right there is clear proof that you guys are neo-Nazi little bitches. You little sniveling trolls are a bunch of neo-Nazi terrorists. You're a bunch of white supremacist little faggots. Oh, and here's another thing I realized. You guys talk about hating me, right? And Golden Frieza, I know you've seen this shit in the comments, dude. I know you've seen what goes on. These guys talk about hating me all the time. Well, if you hate me, then why do you watch my shit? Why do you give me views? Why do you even acknowledge that I exist? If I'm such a piece of shit, why acknowledge me? Clearly, I'm doing something you guys aren't, which is standing up for motherfuckers like me. Y'all just mad. Y'all are mad that Tibbs got me out of the bullshit. That's all it is. You're mad that I exposed Kate. And that Tibbs exposed all of you trolls. Oh, and y'all sit there and say that I'm talentless and I can't do this, I can't do that. Oh, this guy is shit. This guy can't do anything. Well, I beg to differ on that. Starting with this. Oh, and going to Frieza? I'm not saying this to be disrespectful. So, please don't take it as disrespect. But Tibbs works his ass off just as hard as I do. So don't ever put him down. Because he works just as hard as I do on here. I work my ass off on here. Super hard. He works his ass off on his YouTube channel. Twice as hard. In a lot of cases. He does work a lot harder than even I do. So don't ever discredit what that man does. Because he's a hard worker. He really is. And then Frieza, it's funny you say that. It's funny you say that because that was literally the next song I was going to do. Waiting for the break of day. Now, as you guys know, a lot of these neo-Nazis have been popping back up on the internet. And a lot of you guys, I'm sure, have noticed that these neo-Nazis come in the form of trolls or in the form of online terrorists. They want to sit there and leave people like myself and you guys living in fear. They want the whole world to fear them. Well, you know what? As somebody that has something to say about that. And And I think you guys might know this man. He's a rather popular vocalist who started out in the 2000s. And this person's band is very much worldwide known. But I'm gonna let him speak on the matter. Hello, guys. Another Nazi. By Hitler wannabe.
Looking for a deal?
Actually, no, you know what? I got a better one for you guys. We're gonna take it back a little bit here. This one is... Now, the reason why I made that comment in the middle of that song is because it kills me seeing good people like you guys that are in the comments, that are on YouTube supporting me or trying to show support for me. It kills me seeing you guys get attacked the very same way that I get attacked. Or did get attacked, I should say. Like, dude, that shit breaks my fucking heart when I see that shit, man. Because you guys are good fucking people. Every one of you guys that's ever shown love, shown any kind of support of any kind. No matter whether it's big, small, personal messages, whatever. It kills me seeing you guys being attacked like that. All because you guys show support for somebody like me who genuinely wants to help make the world a little bit of a better place. Like, what's so wrong about wanting to have the world be a better place? What's so wrong with that? What? And this is a question for you trolls, aka you neo-Nazi terrorists out there. What's so wrong about a weird-looking motherfucker like me trying to make the world a better place? Trying to help people through their problems? Trying to share my story to inspire people? What's so wrong about that? I mean, I don't see anything wrong with it. Adatha, Golden Frieza, Drift X, do you guys see anything wrong with that? Because I don't. I don't see anything wrong with wanting to help people. I mean, if helping people was a crime, hey, I'm guilty as charged, and I'm not afraid to say it. Oh, you're good, man. Yo, whenever you're done, man, send me that shit. I want to hear it. If you need my email, let me know. I'll send it to you. I'll send you my email as soon as it's done. Or as soon as you're done, man, let me know. If you need my email, I'll send it to you. That way you can send me the song whenever it's done. Because I definitely want to hear it. I want to see what you got. I got you 1 cent, bud. I dig you, man. Oh, you're good, Joe Tex. Hey, I feel it, dude. Back when COVID hit, back when I actually had a job during COVID, I did the same shit, dude. I was constantly doing shit in and out all the time, so I get it. Awesome, man. Can't wait to hear it.
Go into the fold and turn website layouts into an art form with Wix Studio.
The results of the Patreon exclusive 10 second songs poll.
Hold up. I don't get the right effect for this. No. Oh, yeah. It is the right effect. Alright. So. No. I did not want Space Maker.
All are in. Coming in first place is the fan favorite for Bad Guy in 20 Styles, Breaking Benjamin. So here's Breaking Bad Guy featuring Jared Dines.
You know we gotta do it.
Okay. I don't know. Oh shit. I didn't realize that shit would make my fucking head sweat. Oh shit. And yeah, I would, but yeah. And see, I would do that, but there's only one problem. I don't want anybody getting their hands on my shit. You know, like based bitch face shaman. You know, based shaman, the little bitch of YouTube that likes to pretend to be me. Yeah, I'm not risking him getting my shit and doing what he does. That ain't happening. Oh, and based shaman, if you do see this, fuck you. you fucking punk ass coward. If anything, you're a fucking music thief. You're taking my image, my voice, and my likeness and using it. Therefore, you are indeed a thief. Now, we're going to be doing a couple of songs by a very good friend of mine that is actually an amazing artist in his own right. And this dude has actually done a lot for my family in the past.
Bipolar 1, I got help to push back.
I got help.
And if you guys can relate to this back. One,
we got help.
This one's for you guys.
With Vivaldi.
Once daily prescription.
Hey guys, look. We have a major fucking pedo in the mix. Hey Scarecrow, why are you such a pedo, you motherfucker? Why you gotta be a little bitch? Why you such a pedo? Trust me, I know about you, bro. You're a fucking pedophile, little bitch. You got caught being a pedo. And my boy Tibbs, my motherfucking brother, called you out for it, didn't he? Yeah, he did, didn't he? You're just mad because you got caught, bitch. And guess what? You know what we do to pedophiles around here. We do this. I want everybody in the comments right now to put what I just put in the comments. I want to see you guys right now put hashtag fuck pedophiles. I want to see every one of you guys doing that right now to show this little chomo what the fuck is up. Something tells me you got something particularly wrong with you. Goodbye. Dumb fuck. Now, question everybody here, man. How many of you guys are ready to get wild right now? How many of y'all ready to turn this shit up to a 10? Fuck it.
Full How many of you guys ready to turn this up to a full fucking 11? Get hands-on with emerging technologies. Whether you're on campus or online, we offer degrees in...
Now, before I get into this next one, man, I want to explain something. Because there is a story behind this song. This song was actually done by a very good friend of mine. And there was a day a few years ago when me and this friend had a conversation. Because I met this dude through a mutual friend on Facebook a while back. And we ended up in the same Facebook group together. Not knowing that this dude does music. And this dude didn't know about my background, about how I was born, what I went through. And so we got to talking. And he took everything I said and put it in this song you guys are about to hear. This song is literally my life. Like, this song is literally me. Like, this is my anthem. This is my theme song, essentially. Like, this is a song that is about my life. So, this song definitely does hold a very, very, very special place in my heart. And to my friend that did the song, I want to say thank you, man. I still listen to this on daily, almost. And I do appreciate what you've done, man, for sure. This song is called Story of Mine. Before I jump into this, man, this song right here. Well, first off, I got a question. How many of you guys have dealt with a toxic or a very abusive relationship with one of your exes or even your significant other? Because I myself am a victim of abuse by a lot of my exes. And it's funny. A lot of people think that men don't get abused in relationships, but a lot of the times we do. You just don't hear about it. And I wanted to do this song because this song deals around a lot of that. This song deals around abuse and toxicity. So if you guys are in that shit, just know that you guys are not alone. I went through that, and I'm sure some of the people here in the comments have gone through that as well at one time or another. This song is called Toxic. Yo, what up? I got you, man. I'll definitely check it out for a chance I get.
At Full Sail, our technology programs are designed with a different approach.
Now I'm gonna leave you guys off on this right here, and then I have still have to do, but I wanted to leave you guys off with a little bit of a prayer in a sense. For those of you that are religious, or even if you're not.
Tax Act is here to remind you, you have to do your taxes. Let's get them over with.
When you've got the number one pick and the number one chocolate chip,